हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज डॉक्टर अमिता तेलंग, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस, गुरुकुल महिला महाविद्यालय रायपुर. इन द सब्जेक्ट ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम, लेट अस सी टुडे द टॉपिक प्रोसेस मैनेजमेंट. इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल सी फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन, देन बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट, देन प्रोसेस मैनेजमेंट बेसिक्स, एंड देन ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम रोल्स इन प्रोसेस मैनेजमेंट. So first we will see the introduction. A program does nothing unless its instructions are executed by a CPU. So a process is a program in execution. A time-shared user program such as a compiler is a process. A word processing program being run by an individual user on a PC is a process. A system task such as sending output to a printer can also be a process. It is possible to provide system calls that allow processes to create sub-processes to execute concurrently. So we can say that a process can be thought of a program in execution. A process will need certain resources such as CPU time, memory, files, and IO devices to accomplish its task. These resources are allocated to the process either when it is created or when it is executing. So a process is a unit of work in most systems. Systems consist of a collection of processes. Operating system process execute system code and user process execute user code. So all these processes may execute concurrently or parallelly. Although traditionally a process contained only a single thread of control, as it ran, most modern OS now support process that have multiple threads. So the operating system is responsible for activities in connection with process and thread management, such as creation and deletion of both user and system process, the scheduling of process, and the provision of mechanisms for synchronization, communication, and deadlock handling for the process. Let us move to the basic concept of process management. A process needs certain resources, including CPU time, memory, file, and IO devices to accomplish its task. These resources either given to a process when it is created or allocate to it while it is running. So, various physical and logical resources that a process obtained when it is created, various initialization data may be passed along. For example, consider a process whose function is to display the status of a file on the screen of a terminal. The process will be given the name of the file as an input and will execute the appropriate instructions and system calls to obtain display the desired information on the terminal. And when the process display the desired information on the terminal and when the process terminates, the operating system will reclaim any reusable resources. So, if we talk about early computer systems, so it should be noticed that early computer systems allow only one program to be executed at a time. This program had complete control of the system and had access to all the system's resources. In contrast, current day computer systems allow multiple programs to be loaded into memory. This evolution required firmer control and more importantly various programs, and these needs results in the notion of process. So this is the basic concept behind the process. Now let us see process management basics. So we emphasize that a program by itself is not a process. As we already discussed this point, process is an active entity. A single threaded process has one program counter specifying the next instruction to execute. and the execution of such a process must be sequential. The CPU executes one instruction of the process after another until the process completes. Further, at any time, one instruction at most is executed on behalf of the process. Thus, although two processes may be associated with the same program, they are nevertheless considered two separate execution sequences. And when we discuss about multi-threaded process, it has multiple program counters, each pointing to the next section to execute for a given thread. So all these processes can potentially execute concurrently by multiplexing on a single CPU. Let us move to the subtopic operating system role in process management. This is the most important thing, a process in operating system, because operating system is the only interface that between user and the computer. So everything which is going on, which is going to used in operating system is using the process. So as we already know this thing, that a process is a program in execution and it has more than the program code, which is sometimes known as text section. It also includes the current activity such as the program counter and content of the processor register. A process generally also includes the process stack, which contains temporary data, function parameter, return addresses, and data section, which contains global variables. So here we highlight that a program by itself is not a process. A program is a passive entity, such as a file containing a list of instructions stored on disk, whereas a process is an active entity, means every time a process is running in a computer. But a program is not running every time. That's why a process is an active entity. With a program counter specifying the next instruction to execute a set of associated resources. So in operating system, as we know this fact that that operating system works for the full time with the computer system. So the operating system is responsible for following activities in connection with process management: scheduling processes and threads on the CPU, creating and deleting both user and system processes, suspending and resuming processes, providing mechanisms for process synchronization, and providing mechanism for process communication. So here, in connection with this, we can say that a process has many states also, because it is running all the time. So running all the time, it means that it must be in different states when it is running. We will discuss this topic with greater brief in our next sections. But for now, I want to tell some of the states of regarding your process. They are new state, the process is being created. Second is running state, instructions are being executed. Next is waiting state, the process is waiting for some event to occur. Ready state, the process is waiting to be assigned to a processor. And terminated means the process has finished execution. We will see this section in greater detail in our later videos. In our next section, we will see device management. Thank you very much.